Hi, I'm Phil Collen, and this is 20 Things You Didn't Know About Steve Clark, and this is the fourth instalment. I dressed exactly the same as the third instalment. I put the same t-shirt on, used the same guitar, and actually grew the beard out exactly the same. So it was a very precise, precision kind of thing. So we had a little bit of continuity, or flow, as they call it. So here we go. Steve's family took most of the guitar, actually all of the guitars, and obviously when he died there was all stuff in a locker and in his house and stuff like that, so they took some. But many years later, we were clearing out a Def Leppard locker, and there was one of these Les Pauls, a black Les Paul, that Joe kind of hid and then presented to me on my 40th birthday. So I actually ended up using that on some of the Man Ray stuff. I think I use that on the rhythm guitar track on the first song, This Is. It's really fast and furious. I don't really know how to play it now. You know what? I've forgotten how to play it. But you know, the track This Is, that's Steve's Les Paul. I remembered. Yeah, a lot of the time he used standard pickups and, you know, whatever was on the Gibson, but I always used Imazio, and, you know, we'd use each other's guitars occasionally. Steve would use my guitar more so because I have fantastic guitars, and there's one in particular that was the main guitar on the Asteria album. It's actually called Felix. It's a Fender Stratocaster. It had an Ibanez pickup in it. It had been really messed around with, and he'd play it all the time, this one. I'd go, oh, I like that guitar, huh? So he would use that, but for most of the time, on his Les Pauls, he'd have the standard Gibson pickups, and I think on the double neck, he had that as well, actually. Me and Steve are the most useless guitar tech people in the world. I can barely change a string, so it takes me... my tech is amazing, actually. I've always had great techs, but Scotty Appleton's great. Melvin Mortimer, our tour manager, was Steve Clark's tech. And as Melvin would describe himself, everyone talk about techs and great techs, he'd say, yeah, well, I was a great friend of Steve Clark's, because none of us were very technical, but we wanted all these really, really cool technical things done to our guitars. It's actually a very American thing. Back then, you know, you'd have these souped-up guitars. Steve would have a Kayla tremolo arm. I used to have that a lot on my guitars, and I switched to a Floyd Rose later. And DiMarzio pickups. But yeah, my guitars are kind of hot rodded, if you want to call it. It was a very LA, California thing back in the early 80s onward. Now, my guitars are still like that, my PC1s. And Steve's were a little bit like that. You know, you'd have sometimes the pickup just changed, and sometimes a tremolo put in with a locking nut so that it wouldn't go out of tune when you whack the whammy bar. So, but as far as the techie stuff goes, yeah, we were absolutely useless. We come up with the ideas, but we couldn't put them into play. We know a lot of good people. Some of it we did use. Some of it we ended up using on the Adrenalize album, because, you know, if you look at the credits on that, some of them were written with Steve, and we'd done the demos, and I had to learn those songs, you know, when we actually went into the studio. But yeah, some of the stuff we'd done on multi-track, the other stuff, yeah, on cassette. We all walk around with cassettes. I do it on my iPhone now, but we used to have these little cassettes, and I still have a little Sony cassette over there that I record ideas onto, and it's priceless. Steve used to do that all the time, and yeah, there are a couple of songs that were floating around that Steve didn't quite finish, but almost. So I'd like to think that one day we'd actually get those out and they would see the light of the day. One in particular I can think of, so yeah. Not really. He always had kind of a bit of a quirky taste, you know. So he would like bands like The Cure and stuff like that, and interesting guitar sounds. You know, they would have interesting guitar stuff, and not necessarily what we've been doing. But you know, again, we're all like that in Def Leppard. But he likes some really quirky alternative stuff, but he'd turn it around and make it commercial. He could tell what was commercial and what sounded good, and he would come up with ideas like that. Even if he heard something very obscure and a bit weird, he could take something out of that and make it kind of poppy or kind of catchy. And I think that was, so I think it'd have carried on in that theme. Obviously there's so much stuff out there now, and with the advent of the computer and the fact that we can all do, you know, amazing things with loops and samples and strings and Thai or Indian or African rhythms and all that stuff, I think he'd have really gotten into that side of playing and everything. And I think he'd have probably ended up doing a lot of instrumental music. That's just my speculation, but like really cool kind of movie soundtrack type stuff, because he was into that even back then. So yeah, I think that's where he'd have gone. Here's a little story for you. When we was doing the chorus on Love Bites, the song, Mutt said, you know, play that theme, that lick you do, so, which was... He said, but can you make the vibrato go all the time, so it's like, but without using an effect? And I'm thinking, well not really, because he wanted to go... Yeah, I couldn't do that. So Steve would play the whammy bar while I was playing I'd be playing the lick, you know, I'd be going, and he'd be doing this all the time. So when you listen to it, that's a two-man operation. So.